Namaste. A very warm welcome to all the Rasikas this evening from Srinjan Nrityalaya and Ministry of Culture, Government of India. In our last festival, I spoke about the legacy of Guru Shishya Parampara and presented a few young talented dancers. This tradition that we are following today has handed down from our gurus, our mentors, who have always been busy making excellent dancers out of mere individuals. One cannot deny his or her route while soaring high. So let us find out the journey of our gurus, our mentor, and how they have become Nritya Kovidas under the grace of their revered gurus. As you know, the whole world celebrates women on 8th of March, which is tomorrow. So on the eve of this special day, we are honored to have four great women of high esteem who not only has established themselves as connoisseurs of dance, but also they are successful in other fields too. All of them are a combination of beauty and brain, and of course plays a role model inspiration to all. So let us welcome Padma Vibhushan Dr. Sonal Mansi, Padma Shri awardees Dr. Priyambada Mohanty Hejmari, Shusri Kumkum Mohanty and Shusri Geeta Mahalik. My humble pranam to all these women. We will begin this much waited evening with our first honorable guest, Dr. Sonal Mansingh. Dr. Sonal Mansingh is a prominent Indian classical dancer. Over the years, this veteran dancer has practiced many other forms of dance, including Manipuri, Kuchipudi and Chow, besides Odissi and Bharatanatyam. Besides being an expert dancer, she is a well-known choreographer, teacher, orator and social activist. She is perhaps the first person to explore innovations within traditions and choreographed a wide range of creative production like Kau, Kaluri, Benta and Chayaviti. She worked extensively and diligently under Sri Jivan Pani on the relation of dance and literature. Her passion for art and performing it was never been stopped by even a fatal accident she faced once, where the doctors gave verdict of not returning back to normal life. But her determination and willpower brought back her to stage, and she has been giving flawless performance till now. The President of India nominated Dr. Mansingh in July 2018 in recognition of her lifetime dedication and service to Indian art. She is the recipient of the coveted Padma Vibhushan in 2003 from Sri APJ Abdul Kalam and Padma Bhushan in 1992 from Sri R. Venkatraman. Prime Minister Narendra Modi nominated her as Navratna for Swachh Bharat Mission. Her unique contribution has been her lifelong work using her knowledge to address the socio-cultural issues through her chosen field of dance. As art educator, cultural activist and social motivator. As the founder director of Sri Kamakhya Kalapit Center for Indian Classical Dance, established in 1977 in New Delhi, she teaches several thousand talented students who are carrying the essence of Indian culture globally. She teaches the art as a holistic concept, combining with yoga, music, Sanskrit and cultural tradition of India. So here we see Sonalji sharing her experience from her early years.
नमस्कार जनों छी समस्त ओडिया बंधु बांधव भगिनी को तो शिंजिनी नृत्यालय फाउंडेड बाय श्रीमती अलोका कानुनगो वन ऑफ आर लीडिंग मोस्ट एमिनेंट ओडिसी डांसर्स गुरुज कोरियोग्राफर्स आई वांट टू सेंड कन्वे माय बेस्ट विशेस टू शिंजिन नृत्यालय सेट अप बाय हर and the dance Odissi dance festival that they're going to hold end of this month, February 2021. It was very sweet of Aloka to ask me to speak about my experience with Odissi dance. I think she's given me a very difficult task. Bahut bhari ye ye kaun kahi pari bhi, what shall I say? Because from 1965, how many years was that? When I first came to Odissi, I already was a Bharatanatyam dancer, but at the insistence of my father-in-law, respected Dr. Mayadhar Man Sinha, who took me to Kala Vikash Kendra in Katak, and as if handed me over to Guruji, Guru Kelucharan Mahapatra. And my Odissi began from there. And later, it blossomed out further under the guidance and mentorship of Sri Jeevan Pani, the great lyrical poet scholar of Odisha, I think who has not been recognized enough. His contribution to Odissi music, dance, literature and arts, I think, stands out by any barometer, any benchmark. Anyway, so under his mentorship, I discovered so many old Odia traditions, which I included in my repertory. And therefore, my Odissi repertory remains very eclectic. I would not like to start counting, enumerating, because what I learned under Guruji for those 5 years actually was the traditional items till then and new choreographies which were choreographed for me, on me. I will give a few examples like the Mangala Charana, Manikya Veena Mupalalayantim, and I remember Pandit Bhubaneshwar Mishra and Kelu Babu sitting in the Thoria Sahi house of the Mansingha family at the feet of Dr. Madhan Mansingha, which he was seated. And we were discussing, Bapa was very keen that my Odissi should be different, not just Bhongi Chaha and all that Lolita Labongalata. I said, yeah, but you have to go forward. Now, Mangala Charana at that time was only Pada Pande Gananatha, and also, of course, Namami Bighna Rajatam. So, I said in Bharatanatyam, for example, I have this Matangi, Devi Matangi's Mahavidya's shlokas, and I've been dancing that, and I can offer that to Odissi because, after all, these kind of prayers and hymns and stutis are common to all, they're pan Indian. And thereafter, the same ragas I offered, Malkons, Bageshri, and Durga. And as it was taken into Odissi, which has now become the, I think, staple of all Odissi dancers. Then the Saveri Pallavi, which was called Shringara Pallavi, that was set choreographed for me, where the dancer decorates herself and then the dance, and it was very beautiful. Then, Patha Chhari De Mujibi, Phulatori Je Banamali, that Saveri Gita that was choreographed for me, on me. And very importantly, the last Ashtapadi of Gita Govinda, Kuru Yadunandana Chandana Shishirata Rena Karena Payodhare, Mriga Madapatra Kamatra Manobhava Mangala Kalasha Sahodhare, Nijagada Sayadunandane, Kridati Hadaya Nandane. And when Bapa said, Keru, ଏଇଟା ଏଇ ଅଷ୍ଟପଦୀ ଦେଖିବାକୁ ଚାହୁଁଛି, ତୁମେ ତାକୁ ସୋନାଲ ପାଇଁ କରିବ। ଆଣ୍ଡ କେଳୁ ବାବୁ ସେଟ୍, ମୁଁ ତ ଆଜ୍ଞା ବୁଝୁନି ସଂସ୍କୃତ, ଆଉ ମୁଁ ତ ଜାଣିପାରି ମୁଁ ବୁଝାଉଛି। ତ ଦ ଟାଇମ୍ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଦ ମୋମେଣ୍ଟ ବାପା ଷ୍ଟାର୍ଟେଡ୍ ଏକ୍ସପ୍ଲେନିଂ ଦ ମିନିଂ ଅଫ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଅଷ୍ଟପଦୀ ୱିଥ୍ ଦ ଫର୍ଷ୍ଟ ଫ୍ୟୁ ୱାର୍ଡ୍ସ ଇଟ୍ସେଲ୍ଫ, କେଳୁ ସାର୍ ୱାଜ୍ ଲୁକିଂ ଡାଉନ୍ ଲାଇକ୍ ଅ ନ୍ୟୁଲି ମ୍ୟାରିଡ୍ ୱୁମେନ୍, ଆଣ୍ଡ ୟୁ କୁଡ୍ ସି ହି ୱାଜ୍ ସୋ ଏମ୍ବାରାସ୍। ଆଣ୍ଡ ବାପା ଲାଫିଙ୍ଗଲି ସେଡ୍, ଏ କେଳୁ ତୁମେ ଭାଇନ କି, ଆଣ୍ଟ ୟୁ ମ୍ୟାରିଡ୍? ସୋ ଆଇ ମିନ୍ ଆଇ ଏମ୍ ଜଷ୍ଟ ସେଇଙ୍ଗ, ଅଫରିଂ ଦିସ୍ ଲିଟିଲ୍ ଆସାଇଡ୍ ଟୁ ଟେଲ୍ ୟୁ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଆଇ ହାଭ୍ ସିନ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଟାଇମ୍ସ ଆଣ୍ଡ କୁରୁ ୟଦୁ ନନ୍ଦନ ରିମେନ୍ ଷ୍ଟିଲ୍ ଟୁଡେ। ଅଫକୋର୍ସ ଲେଟର୍ ଅନ୍ ଆଫ୍ଟର ଆଇ ମୁଭ୍ଡ ଅୱେ ହି ଅଲ୍ଟର୍ଡ ଇଟ୍ ଅ ଲିଟିଲ୍ ବିଟ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ବ୍ରଟ୍ ସମ୍ ଅଦର୍ ସଞ୍ଚାରୀସ୍, ବଟ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଅଷ୍ଟପଦୀ ୱିଥ୍ ମୀ ରିମେନ୍ସ ଆବ୍ସୋଲ୍ୟୁଟ୍ଲି ଦ ୱେ ଇଟ୍ ୱାଜ୍। ଆଣ୍ଡ ରାସେ ହରିମିହ ବିହିତ ବିଲାସମ୍, ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଅଷ୍ଟପଦୀ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ୱାଜ୍ କୋରିଓଗ୍ରାଫ୍ଡ ଅନ୍ ମୀ ଫର୍ ମୀ। ୱି ୱେର୍ ଗୋଇଂ ଟୁ ଦ ଟ୍ରିପ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଫୋର୍ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରିଜ୍, ICCR was sending us in a delegation, 1968. And before that, so much was composed and choreographed. And I was dancing Odissi, Guruji was playing the Pakhwaj. And I memorable, there are photos there, videos, those were Katheni, no videos. What I want to mention is that in 1969, for the first time, Madras, as it was called, not Chennai, Madras saw Odissi. Before that, we were told that Yamini ji or Rita Chatterjee or Indrani ji were doing some one or two items here and there. But nobody took it seriously. And you know, Madras was then the Mecca, shall we say, the center, the Vrindavana of Indian classical arts. So, and to convince these Vidwans, the great Rukmini Devi, M.S. Subbalakshmi, Pattamar, Vasanta Kumari, Guru Ramayya Pillai, Guru Chokkalingam Pillai, Guru Ellappa Pillai, you name them, and they were all there. And the great scholar, the great Vidwan, Dr. V. Raghavan, and such people were there in the audience, my first program. And when Rukmini Devi said at the end of it, that today I can say Odissi is as much, if not more, classical as is Bharatanatyam. In 1969, just imagine, Odissi was just blossoming. And that remains to me the greatest compliment of my life. And for Odissi, not for me, for Odissi. Then coming to Odissi proper, my experience under Jivanda, my mentor, my guru, my guide, was so fantastic that every few months he was bringing something, I would ask him something. You know, the Upanishadic tradition of asking questions and getting answers. And answers had to be also searched for, about the Odissi music tradition, the indigenous tradition, the Chariya Gitis, the Ragas of Gita Govinda, which were mentioned by Jayadev, which we found in Sangeeta Ratnakara, the bringing Mayurbhanj Chhau. There are three Chhaus, one is Bengal Purulia Chhau, one is now Jharkhand Saraikela Chhau, both have masks. The third Chhau, which is in Odisha, from the Mayurbhanj, which was a kingdom, one of the, I think, largest kingdoms, one of the top five kingdoms, Chhau. And this Chhau doesn't wear mask, it is more martial and performed by there's a tribal element, there's a warrior element, and observations from nature, birds and animals. It's a fantastic amalgam. I was the first woman to learn Mayurbhanja Chhau and present it in Delhi in 1973. So I was asking Jivanda, as I call Sri Jivanpani, ke Jivanda, Odissi is all last year, but to declare it Shastriya, both the elements have to be there, Tandava and last year and Tandava. I don't see the Tandava. And he said, okay, you will find it in Mayurbhanj Chow maybe. Because the Tribhanga is there, it's called Dharana. The chowk is there. And this is from the soil of Orissa. So we went to Baripada. I had seen it before when Bappa had taken me there for the Chaitra Parva, Chaitra Purnima festival. And we had Guru Anand Charan Sai, the great Kadhu Babu, teaching me. And that is how the Mayurbhanj Chow for the first time was amalgamated into Odissi. Now it has become commonplace. So there is so much more that I've experienced. And when people ask me, how do you look at Bharatanatyam and Odissi? Now I say that I have two eyes, but one vision. So I have found Bharatanatyam, which I started learning from age of 7, and Odissi, as supplementary and complementing each other. Bharatanatyam has a majesty, a different kind, a geometrical majesty, and it conforms to the Carnatic mode of music. It is fantastic, the layakari, the extensions. And Odissi has the filigree that you see in the Odia sculptures, in the Odia filigree ornaments, and the Odia beautiful saris. Today, I'm not wearing Odissi sari. I need not wear it all the time to declare that I'm an Odissi dancer. I'm an Odissi dancer. It is in every pore of my being. But what I'm saying is that Odissi and Bharatanatyam, they both remain wonderful in their own framework. They complement each other. And I'm so grateful to the Great Mother, our Goddess, for having given me the opportunity to learn both under great gurus and not to have mixed up, but to have juxtaposed each other. Another great, I would say great choreography, Dvivarna, the two colors. And Dvivarna had my Bharatanatyam musicians seated on one side, my Odissi musicians seated on other side. I was wearing a neutral costume, and you know how it was interwoven, like the choti, that 4 bars of Alaripu, 4 bars of Sthayi, like that, the entire. Then the Pallavi and Jatiswaram, then the Abhinaya, the Varnam and the Sabhinaya, and Tillana and Mokhya or Natangi. So what I say again, I repeat myself, that Odissi remains with me as my alter ego. And I'm so grateful to Odisha, to Jagannatha, Subhadra, Balabhadra for having accepted me. And even today, a lot of people think I'm from Odisha. I'm a Gujarati by birth. My Matrubhasha is Gujarati. Odia is my new birth in this birth. And Odissi remains, Odia culture remains very, very dear to me. I respect it greatly. I again wish you all the best, and may you keep working in the wonderful direction that you've taken. Aloka, my dear Aloka, may Bhagavati bless you. Namaskar. Mega
शिखंडा का दामा रे mani rasana vasana maranani mani rasana vasana bharanani shubhasaya basaya
I would say Guruji has done a total justice by choreographing Saveri or Shringar Pallavi and Manikya Veena for such a beautiful and learned person like you, Sonaji. Thank you so much. Now we move on with our second honorable guest, Dr. Priyambada Mohanty Hejmadi. Dr. Hejmadi is an exceptional achiever and the First Lady Vice Chancellor of Odisha. She has received the prestigious Padma Shri in Science and Engineering and the Central Sangeet Natak Academy Award in Culture. Being a leading figure in culture, she played a significant role in bringing Odissi on the national platform. She has also received Sarangadev Fellowship, Odissi Samman, Jeevan Ratna and Bhavans Samman for her overall contribution. Few of her state level awards are Odisha Sangeet Natak Academy Award, Kavi Samrat Upendra Bhanja Samman for her lifetime achievement in Odissi, Governor's Plaque and many others. She was the president of Odisha Sangeet Natak Academy and a member of major leading cultural organization like the Central Sangeet Natak Academy, Eastern Zonal Cultural Center, Central Board of Film Certificate. Priyambada ji has penned down two books, Odissi Dance and The Goti Boa, The Boy Dancer of Odisha. She established the stream of art, literature and culture for the first time in University of Sambalpur during her tenure as Vice Chancellor, which is funded by UGC. So here we have Dr. Priyambada Mohanty Hejmadi.
Greetings to everyone. I am happy to see that Alok Kanango is holding an Odissi dance festival with senior established dancers. She has requested me to say a few words to all of you. As I was the first one to take the dance outside Odisha, I was the first one to perform this dance in the first inter-university youth festival where I represented Utkal University in the classical dance category. I was not allowed to participate as no one had heard about my style, but due to our persistent demand, they allowed me to perform. This was highly appreciated by the audience and connoisseurs. It was fortunate that the then legendary art critic of Statesman, Dr. Charles Fabry, was in the audience. And he insisted that Odissi may not be familiar to them, but Priyambada's dance had all the classical elements. Although my style didn't fit into the official categories, I was awarded the third place in classical dance, and interestingly enough, the style was not. This actually laid the foundation for the recognition of Odissi ultimately. Odissi is recognized as the fastest growing classical dance form, becoming pan-Indian and then pan-international. It is, I am told, the second most practiced classical dance in the international scale. Since many generations have taken up Odissi, which became popular due to its sculptures and lyrical qualities, scholars, gurus, dancers and connoisseurs have made this possible. Unfortunately, during my time, it was not possible to take it as a profession. People ask me, why did you leave dance? The truth is, in my days, accompanists were not there. Kedosar used to go with me to play the pakhoj. Balakrishna used to go with me to sing. And they were both working in music schools here, and the propriety didn't allow them to leave headquarters very often. And they said, if you want to go with Priyambada so often, then leave the job. Then I explored the possibility of tape recorders. And then that was not satisfactory, because in those days, the sound system was not sophisticated. I'll put the tape recorder near the mic, the speaker, and then whatever, used to come out, the sound, that was not really satisfactory. So I knew that it is not possible to take it as a career. And in the meantime, I got a scholarship to go to US. But that doesn't mean that I left dance. Dance has been with me all the time. I have given performances in USA and in other places because I had the taped music. Then more than that, I have gone deep into the basics of Odissi, and I have written 3 books, 2 on Odissi dance and 1 on Gotik verse. The first one is a primer by Naxwant Foundation. The other 2 were published by Aryan International. I am very happy to say that our Padma Vibhushan Sonal Mansingh, who is here today participating, released the book for me in the Habitat Center in 2015. Then the other thing I would like to say is that although dance is very, very popular now, I find the intellect is lacking. Dancers are not going into the basics, what is the foundation, or into the shastras, shastric base, or the music patterns. They are just mimicking one another, and sort of it becomes very, very repetitive. I'd like to also say that Sonal Mansingh, who is here, she is one of a kind. She is a Vidwan in her own right. She had a knowledge of sastras, the music, and everything you can think of, cultural or intellectual. And that is why she is respected all over the world. And she was given the highest, civilian award, Padma Vibhushan, and not to speak of the final Rajya Sabha membership, which was given to her by no less than the President of India. I am very happy, Sonal, and very proud of you. Then we come to the current stage, since senior dancers are here. I would say, please go to the background of the dance form, go to our literature, and go to our shastras, go to our temples and see for yourself what the sculptures are and try to get some more new dimensions into the Odyssey without really violating the basics. And I'm sure that many of you can do that if you want to. Now, I am always asked that how come you are a scientist and you are interested in Odyssey and writing on all that? I would like to answer that dance and science are two parts, two sides of the same coin. In science, you have to be totally precise, but for experimental purposes, you have to have the imagination and the creativity which goes with dance. But dance, I would say dance is totally scientific. The talas, the rhythms, the postures, the body movements, a lot of work is being done on these in different classical dance categories in India. And I would love to see some Odyssey dancers explore the body language of the body and how we use it, the balance and all. This kind of research is necessary for Odyssey as it is becoming very, you know, common to repeat the same dancers and just record music. That doesn't add on ultimately if you want to take it up seriously. Then at the end, I would like to say that it is a pleasure for me to participate in the seminar with Sonal, who she's a younger sister to me. I've always loved the way she has conducted herself and has added new things and added more and more and explored into so many things besides dance, and has a command over our literature, our background and our shastras and music, everything you can think of. Sonal, I am very proud of you. Now coming to the organizer Alok, I am very happy to say that Alok has also a very research minded person, and she has done a lot of work on the Gotipuas, and as far as I know and I have seen, she has utilized some of the Gotipua movements in her choreography, which is very good. So here are two creative persons who are involved in this seminar, and I am sure that the dancers will emulate them and follow them. With these words, I would like to bless all of you, and I hope you gain a lot of ideas from this seminar. Thank you. Hey.
चंद्र दिवाकर नेत्रधारे जय भवत भूषित वक्र धरे जय भैरव देह लीन परे जय अंधक दैत्य विमुख करे नमो
जय भगवती देवी
नमस्तस्य नमस्तस्य नमो नमः तद्रीं तदिरे
दिने
पदबंदे पदबंदे गणनाथ गुण धाम जय हे गुण धाम जय हे पदबंदे पदबंदे
Priyambadaji, the whole Odissi world is grateful to you for taking the first step forward to show the dawn of Odissi. Thank you so much. Now we move on to present our next honorable guest, Sushri Kumkum Mohanty. The recipient of Padma Shri Award, Kumkum Mohanty started her professional career by joining the Indian Postal Service after her post-graduation in 1970. While she was in deputation to Odisha, she established the Odissi Research Center, which is now well known as Guru Kelucharan Mahapatra Odissi Research Center. This is an autonomous body under Government of India. Later on, she joined Odisha government and retired as Director, Culture of Department in 2004. As the Chief of Odissi Research Center, she could give a new orientation to the style of Odissi dance and music. The mega festivals like Konark and Mukteshwar festivals, which has become a prestigious platform for the dancers for getting recognitions, was initiated by none other than Kumkumji. She has also received Central Sangeet Natak Academy Award, Odisha Sangeet Natak Academy Award, Kalidas Samman from Government of Madhya Pradesh, and Best Teacher Award from IIT Bhubaneswar. She published two books on Odissi dance grammar, The Odissi Dance Pathfinder, Volume 1 and Volume 2, which are one of a kind in Indian classical dance, emphasizing on the techniques and its unique style of Odissi. She established her institution Geeta Govinda at Bhubaneswar. We are pleased to present Sushri Kumkum Mohanty.
I must be thankful to you to have given me this opportunity to tell about my contribution to Odissi dance and the development of the dance grammar and the Odissi Research Center, choreography, compositions, performances, etc., etc. I must say that when Sankaravarana Pallavi was composed in my house with Guruji, Pandit Bhubaneswar Mishra, Rakhal Mahanty, three of them, a big question arose in my mind. I asked Guruji, what is the name of this poison? When we put the hill in Trivanga, from Kunchita Pada to Bilagna Parshni Pacha, I asked him, what is the name of this poison? He said, no, you just copy, I don't know. You just copy what I am doing. That was a big question mark in my mind. And secondly, when Guruji used to compose the items in my house late at night, and next morning I used to go to the university, come back, and then again we sit down for composition. There was no method of writing and there was no video recording system at that time. If I forget what has been composed, then it has to be recreated. Had there been some sort of notation system of the footwork, I could have jotted down. But these two things were actually plaguing me throughout my life until Odissi Research Center was established. In Abhinav we have the language and the lyric and the hand gestures to mention them. But for pure dance it was difficult. Then when I was posted at Calcutta as director of foreign post I made a scheme and gave it to Government of Odisha, like codification, notation, dissemination and documentation. These are the four subjects on which Odisha Research Center project was made, and the then Chief Minister, Mr. Janakiraman Patnaik, accepted it. He brought me on deputation and we started with a lot of difficulties without funds in the archive building. And my first job was to get together all the gurus like Guru Kelchara Mahapatra, Pandit Bhuvaneswar Mishra and Balakrishna Das. What was happening in my parents' house, I wanted to have the same thing under one roof with the support of the government, so that many Odia students can learn from Guruji and at the same time can do the problem which was plaguing me. So from 65 till 70, until I joined the All India Postal Services, I have performed profusely throughout India and abroad, and many new compositions. Each time there is a program in Delhi, I would force Guruji to give me a new Pallavi, otherwise I won't repeat the old one. That is how the repertoire enhanced, and because of my jiddi that I won't dump the old one, we must do it new one. But after 70, there was a gap of nearly 12-13 years. Then when I was brought in deputation to Odisha government and Odisha Research Center was established, Guruji joined on 24th February. Odisha Research Center started in 84. And my first seminar was taking all the Gotipur maestros, Maharis and Pankaj sir, Deva sir, Chalu sir, then coming down to all the teachers, gurus who are teaching abroad, in Delhi and Bombay and in Bhubaneswar, till Ramani, Anjan Jena and Gangadhar Pradhan. Then all the stalwart dancers like Sanjukta Panigrahi, Sonal Man Singh, Dr. Minati Mishra. It was a gathering of nearly 35 to 40 people, and my subject was, how did you learn Odissi dance? That is going back to 60 years. And no question was allowed. All of them showed, and it was video recorded, all of them showed the process in which they learned. From this seminar, I got the 14 points of the Odissi Pathfinder Volume 1. Then comes the detailing part of it. Detailing in the sense, the foot positions, all the foot positions, since I was a dancer and I wanted to do the same thing, I took from Guruji's photographs, my photo, whatever came to our mind, which are mostly used in dance. They were photographed and drawn. Then a team of experts, we sat down to nomenclature them. And each foot position was nomenclature. But I must say in the beginning, apart from Guruji, Sanju, my colleague, helped me most in most of the research work. In the foot movement, you see, we are pan-Indian strategists are there, Natyashastra, Abhinaya Darpana, but we wanted to make our own grammar. Each classical dance has taken something from pan-Indian strategists. But once you are established as a classical dance, you must have your own local identity. So, Pankaj sir had given quite a number of names for these foot positions, foot movements. Then all the aspects which are there in learning Odissi for us after that. And along with these names, we had to use the Abhinaya Darpana's Griva movement, head movement, neck movement, eye movement. Everything else was there. And then most important, another thing, the Brahmaris. The Brahmaris which are used in Odissi, apart from the Abhinaya Darpana thing, we have our own Brahmari system. Like that, after the detailing was done and the nomenclatures were done, the book was published. And it was published in the sense, it was appreciated by the then Prime Minister, Chief Minister so much. He didn't want to leave me. Simultaneously, when the dance research was going on, I made
seminar with all the musicologists and musicians from south of Odisha, mostly those who matter at that time. There was a big seminar on Odissi music. The main intention was to find out the structural pattern of Odissi Raga, which is most important in order to establish Odissi as a classical music. Our grammars should be same.
Poetry in motion and sculptures. No, these are not my words, but showered by the critics on her. One of the outstanding exponent of Odissi, Geetaji has received the prestigious Padma Shri Award, the Central Sangeet Natak Award, and Odisha Sangeet Natak Academy Award for her overall contribution to the art world. She has been awarded with a senior fellowship by Ministry of Culture, Government of India, Grameen Award, Palli Shri Award, Odissi Cine Critic Awards, Pankaj Charan Das Awards, and many others. She has been invited to perform in major festivals in India like Khajuraho, Ellora, Elephanta, Mukteshwar, Kalidas Samaroho, Nisha Gandhi and many others. She travelled extensively to foreign lands for presenting her dance recital in reputed occasions and events like India Night at Berlin, Calgary in Canada, and other performances. Under the invitation of ICCR, she has also performed in Silk Road International Fair in China and India Trade Fair in Mongolia. Recently, she performed along with her repertory in Festival of India in Russia, organized by Government of India. Apart from being a dancer, she is a great choreographer. Her choreographies are praised by critics and connoisseurs. She is the member of several expert committees of the Ministry of Culture, Government of India, and also a member of advisory committee in the Ministry of Defense, Youth Affairs and Sports, Government of India. She is also a former member of General Council of Central and Odisha Sangeet Natak Academy. She has established her own institution, Geeta's Upasana, in New Delhi. So, let us welcome Sushri Geeta Mahalik.
Namaskar, I'm Geeta Mahalik. First of all, I would like to thank Guru Alok Kanungu to have invited me to her 2 days Odissi Dance Festival. Thank you, Alok, and my best wishes are always with you. Today, I would like to share with you all my journey in Odissi. From my childhood, I was very passionate about the dance. I started learning from late Guru Sri Deva Prasad Das when I was a small child. Then throughout my school and college, I kept on learning and performing. Then I got married to a bureaucrat and shifted to Delhi. There I learned from legendary Guru Padma Sri Mayadhar Raut Ji. I have the blessings of my 2 gurus and I am very grateful to them. They have shaped me as a dancer. Then in Delhi, I kept on performing in India and abroad also. My husbands and my family had given me full support. Without their support, I couldn't have done anything in my life. And whatever little I have achieved in my life, this is the blessings of Lord Jagannath and blessings of my Guru. I always wanted to keep balance between my passion and my family, because my family are also very important to me. It was difficult that time, but I never stopped dancing. One thing I have realized in life, if you have a passion and dedication and devotion with lots of hard work, you can achieve your goal. These days, the government also has introduced a new education policy. From the 6th grade, you can choose your subject and pursue it till your 12th class. Maybe it is art or carpentry or anything else. Then after that, you can take up as a profession. Earlier, we were thinking that we are learning dance only as a hobby. We cannot take it as a profession. But these days the concept has really changed. If you are established and if you are good at it, you can take it as a profession. You can teach also. You can perform globally and earn your living. So one small suggestion and advice to the younger generation. you learn something as a hobby in the beginning, but if you want to take it as a profession, you have to really work hard for that. Then nothing can stop you to achieve your goal. In the end, again, I want to thank Alok to have invited me. Thank you, Alok, and all the best. Jai Jagannath. Namaskar.
Thank you. जमुना स्नहाने गाली घासी आदी है जमुना स्नहाने गाली
कली जहाँ कली सखी
Thank you, Gitaji. It's our immense pleasure to have you among us and get to know about your dedication to this art form. It says, Rome was not built in a day, and so were not these Nritya Kovidas. Their sincere dedication and passion towards their subject has illuminated their names. We are very proud of these women of substance. Thank you so much for adorning this festival. With this, we have come to the end of this festival. Our sincere thanks to Ministry of Culture, Government of India for supporting Shinjan Vidyalaya. Our technical supports are Shankar Sen and Boishali Bhuya for video and editing. Poster designing by Shukradipta Dutta. And lastly, a special thanks to all these Rasikas. Namaste and Shubh Ratri.